A multimeter is a measuring instrument that can measure multiple electrical properties. A typical multimeter can measure voltage, resistance, and current. In today's tutorial, we will learn how to use a multimeter. Multimeter have a dial in the center to select the function and range of selected function. It has two probes, red and black. Black probe will always be placed in the common terminal, while the red probe mostly we place in the volt, ohm terminal. But if we want to measure the current, we will place this red probe in the 10 ampere terminal. Let's see now how we can measure the AC volts across the breaker terminals with the multimeter. First, we will set the multimeter dial at step mentioned as 600 volts AC. We can select 200 volt AC step if we want to measure AC volts less than 200 volts. As you can see, that multimeter display indicates 0.0 volts AC. Now we will place red and black probes on the two output terminals of the motor protector breaker. As soon as probes are placed, multimeters measures the AC volts and displays 380 volts AC on the display. Next, we will see how we can measure the DC volts across the terminals of the 24 volt DC control breaker. First step is to set the dial of the multimeter on the 200 volts range. As you can see, that multimeter display indicates 0.0 volts DC. Now we will place red and black probes on the two output terminals of the control breaker. As soon as probes are placed, multimeters measures the DC volts and displays 24.3 volts DC on the display. As you can see, that negative sign appears on left side of the multimeter. This indicates that red probe of the multimeter is in contact with the negative wire and black probe is in contact with the positive wire. If we reverse the probes, this negative sign disappears. This means that now red probe is in contact with the positive wire and black probe is in contact with the negative wire. This function of the multimeter comes very handy and helps if we want to detect which wire is positive and which wire is negative. Next, we will see how we can measure the resistance with the help of the multimeter. First of all, we will switch off the power. Multimeter malfunctions if we use it to measure the resistance while the power is on. We can select the range of the resistance from 200 ohm to 200 mega ohms by setting the multimeter dial on it. We will set the multimeter dial at 2000 ohms range. Now we can place the multimeter probes at the A1 and A2 terminals of the contactor. As we know that A1 and A2 terminals are coil terminal of the contactor. As you can see that, the multimeter is showing the resistance of the coil as 303.9 ohms. Same way, we can check the value of the small resistances installed on the printed circuit boards. Continuity is the presence of a complete path for the current flow. A digital multimeter's continuity test mode can be used to test switches, fuses, electrical connections, conductors, and other components. A good fuse, for example, should have continuity. Let's check the contacts of the selector switch with continuity test. To do the continuity test with the multimeter, we will set the multimeter dial on the buzzer. As you can see that, the multimeter LCD display's buzzer icon indicates that the multimeter is ready for the continuity test. It also displays OL. This means open circuit, and right now no current is flowing. Next, we will place the multimeter probes on the contacts of the selector switch. As soon as we turn on the selector switch, the multimeter shows 0.3 ohms reading, and its buzzer starts to sound. This means that current is flowing through the switch terminals, and it is working okay. Multimeter can also test the diodes. To test the diode, we will set the multimeter mode to diode test by turning the dial at the continuity, and then we have to press the select button once to select the diode test mode. We can test a diode in two steps. In first step, we will put red probe on the cathode side of the diode and black probe on the anode. The multimeter shows OL. This means no current is flowing into diode in the reverse polarity. In second step, we will switch interchange the probes and place red probe on the anode and black probe on the cathode. This time multimeter showing 0.6 volts. This indicates that diode drops 0.6 volts in this test. This means that diode is okay. Next, very important thing we can measure with the multimeter is the current. We can measure few amperes of the current with the multimeter. For example, if want to see how much amperes this bulb is drawing from the battery, we can use this multimeter to measure the current. First, we will set the dial of the multimeter at the 10 ampere range. Next, we will remove the red probe from the volts, ohm terminal, and place this probe in the 10 ampere terminal. Next, we will put these probes in series with switch and bulb terminals. Now probes wires are in series with circuit, and the current will first flow through these probes, and then goes to the bulb. As soon as we turn on the switch, the current flows through the multimeter probes and reaches the bulb and bulb turns on. Multimeter will measure the current and displays it on the LCD display. Same way we can measure the analog output for a 20 mA signal of the pressure or temperature transmitters. If you want to learn more about this, link is in the description box. So, that's the end of today's tutorial. I hope you like it. Please share, like and subscribe this channel and press the bell icon for more videos. Till next time, take care and goodbye.